the first treatment for insomnia, if it is not related to anything else, because if it is related to stress, if it is related to other mental disorders, that's a different issue, because sometimes if we don't take care of those things, insomnia might continue. But now, insomnia alone can be treated by maintaining a good sleep hygiene. Now, the good sleep hygiene is something like this. It refers to a series of healthy sleep habits that can improve our ability to fall asleep and stay asleep. So these habits are the cornerstone for cognitive behavior therapy. Like people who talk about cognitive behavior therapy, they try to do this. So what are the tips? Number one, it's always good to have a consistent time to sleep. Same time to sleep, same time to get up. So let's say 10 in the evening and you get up at 6 o'clock in the morning, for example. Because what is important is to have at least 6 to 8 hours of good sleep. That is what we target for. There are people who can do better with less sleep, but generally it is, the researches have shown that you need minimum of 6 hours of sleep to be totally functional. So even during the weekends, you should have that. The next is, don't go to bed unless we feel sleepy. That's what they say. If we don't fall asleep within 20 minutes, you just get out of the bed and do something else. Don't waste your time just tossing and turning and thinking about something and stressing yourself. It's always good to establish some sort of a relaxing technique before going to bed. Now, how do you get that? There are lots of relaxation audios available in the net. If you have that problem, please go to YouTube or somewhere which can give that guided relaxation which we can use. Sometimes imagery is used, sometimes guided muscle relaxation used. There are two of them. One is called progressive muscle relaxation, where you are consciously relaxing all the muscles. One is just going for a relaxation. So people can use that. They say that use your bed for a certain purpose only. Don't use it for like watching television or doing too many things. That's why your bed is supposed to be used only for sleeping, and make your bedroom quiet and relaxing. It's very good. It's very important. And then as far as possible, put off all the light in the night. Many people have the habit of keeping some dim light or red light or blue light, whatever. But it is, research has shown that actually darkness stimulates the production of something called melatonin in our brain, which is one chemical that is essential for maintaining our biological clock. So if we put on the light, sometimes the melatonin secretion goes down and our sleep can be disturbed. But there are people who can manage to sleep even in bright daylight. That is different, but I'm talking about people who have trouble going to sleep. Your bedroom should be quiet, and the temperature, they say that should be slightly low. Normally the bedroom temperature, they say, should be between 16 to 19 degrees. It's cool, so that you can put a blanket and nicely sleep. Towards the evening, don't go out and expose yourself to too much of light. Now, if there are any devices which can disturb you during your sleep, just put it off. If it is helpful, very mild, soothing music sometimes is helpful. Now, some people get sleep by reading, so if that is the habit, go ahead. But don't read something that is taxing to our mind, something that disturbs us, some relaxing type of a thing. Avoid drinking coffee, tea, or even alcohol at least 2 hours before we go to sleep. And they also advise that don't do heavy exercise towards the evening. If you have to do it at least 2 to 3 hours prior to going to bed. And then the food intake, night food intake should be as less as possible and not very spicy. Because many times what happens is you take very spicy food and then in the night you get that sour type of regurgitation in your mouth that can actually make you get up and it might disturb you. Restrict your fluid intake at least 2 to 3 hours prior to going to bed so that you don't have to get up in the middle of the night, yes, go to bathroom, come back and you are not able to sleep. So these are some of the tips for sleep hygiene.